So, good morning, everybody. It's so nice to be here, and I'm really, really honored to be like here and speaking, the first one to speak here. So, I'm from Finland. I came with Kia and Emmanuel, and thank you for inviting me. It's so great to be here. Today, I'm going to talk about my own experience. How did I integrate to my studies and to Finland? So basically, you told everything about me, what I'm doing nowadays. So this is basically my daily work. So I'm teacher and I'm mentor. I mentor immigrant youth. So basically, I have 300 students in a week. So I teach them, and they are really all immigrant students. So I'm teaching them, and I also give lectures about multicultural, the issues, the challenges, and the good things. So basically, I have been working with Kia, and we have been giving together lectures in Finland, of course. And I have here in also been abroad and giving lecture in abroad also. So this is great, great opportunity. So first, I'm going to tell a bit about myself. I also like to mention about my history and my background, because I'm a bit different, and I come from a different country. But originally, I'm from Iraq. I was born in Iraq, and then the war started, so we had to go to a refugee camp. So this is my family, and we were in the refugee camp, and we were there 2 years. Then we had to go from there. You can see from the pictures, the things were really not right and not really healthy for the kids. So we had to really go. And the war didn't stop in Iraq, so we couldn't go back in our country. So we really had to go from the refugee camp and move on. So we lived in 2 years in refugee camp, and then I had to live with my mother, only with my mother and my siblings, to Finland. And it was really, really hard for my mother to leave her own country. For example, she didn't know how to speak English, and she didn't have any education background. She didn't never study anything. So it was really, really hard to go somewhere she never knew. She never knew what is Finland and where is Finland and anything about Finnish country. And the weather was different, the culture was different, the language was different, so everything was different. How we managed to survive, that was difficult, pretty difficult for my mother, for us also. My mother was really down, she was depressed, and she was really down, down, down. And she couldn't really handle us, and she couldn't raise us. So it was really hard for us to grow in Finland without mother. But this is my background, and this is my history, and it was really hard to grow up in Finland, because in one time I really felt like I am immigrant, and in one time I really felt like I'm a Finnish, but some people really don't see me as a Finnish, and I really had difficulties with that, because I really want to belong in Finland, but the society, the people really didn't accept that, because I really looked like this. And this is hard to accept in Finland. It's really hard. In the 90s, when we came to Finland, we were the first immigrant people in Finland. So there was few, but we were the first one in the 90s. So it was really a new thing in Finland. They didn't know how to accept us. They didn't know how to talk with us. They didn't know how to integrate us. So they didn't have anything, any system at all. So it was really hard. And it was hard for me to grow up there. But in the end, I studied there. I went to the primary school, secondary school, and high school. But in high school, there was a difficulties because my supervisor didn't give me any advice to continue my studies. He said that it's actually good you to start working. And it's good if you start something like cleaning, or restaurant, or nurse, or something else. Don't apply to the university, because you won't manage there. You don't have those skills to manage there. So I never believed in myself to apply to university. It was really, really hard. So I started to work. I really started to work. I was in a bakery. I was in a cleaning team. So we cleaned every office. And it was not my thing. It was really not my thing. Then I started to work in school. I was an assistant in school. So I liked the job. I really liked the job. So I started to work there 2 years. Then the teacher said, why don't you apply to university? I was like, no, it's not my place. They said, what do you mean? I said, my supervisor said the immigrant people don't have the skills, don't manage there. The teacher was like, really? You don't manage there, but you manage with the kids here. You can teach them, you can, you know, play with them. They like you, you like them. You like everything you do. You always come to the school and you're smiling and the kids are smiling. So you like this place. I was thinking, yeah, that's true. Should I really go and apply? I was really nervous and I couldn't, you know, apply for the university because I never saw myself. And university was a place for all white. Not like me, like immigrant people who were studying in university. So I challenged myself and I applied to the university. So I didn't get in the first time. I was like, yes, it was almost, but I did it. I applied. That was the first thing I should, the first step. I should apply and do it. But it has to take, you know, so much courage to step up and take the first step. So I did it. But I didn't manage to make it. So I was thinking, yeah, maybe the supervisor was right. I won't have the skills and I won't, you know, get in. But then I applied a second time and I got in. But before that, before the application, before I applied, before I read to the exam, my mother said, don't apply. Don't apply to the university and don't become a teacher. You don't know what the teacher mean in our country. It's so low, the teacher work, that everybody is laughing at you in our culture, in our religion, in our country, if you apply to the teacher program. So my mom said, if you are going to apply for that, I'm not going to be your mother. So I'm going to leave you alone. And you have to survive alone, yes. So I was really like thinking, what I'm going to do? Like the society is not taking me in and my mother is leaving me. So it was really hard for me to choose. Should I really apply? If I apply and if I get in, my mother will leave me. And if I get in, the society won't accept me. So it was really hard for me. What should I do? Should I go with my culture and respect my culture and go with that? Or should I really fight with the society and go in and chase my dreams? It was really hard and difficult decision for me. But I was thinking, I have to do what is in my head and in my dreams. So I applied next time and I got in and I was really, really happy to get in. But I never knew what kind of challenges I would have in a university. I really didn't have any idea. I was the first immigrant when I got in. My friend said, you will never get in. I said, why? Why I never get in university? They say, do you know how do you look? I said, yes, I know. You're wearing headscarf. Yes, they won't accept that. The teachers won't accept that. The parents won't accept that. The students won't accept that. Nobody accept that. You are just chasing, wasting your time. Please stop it. My friends, all my friends said that. So I was thinking, nobody is supporting me. My friends, no, they are not supporting me. My mother is not supporting me. My society is not supporting me. I'm alone. I'm really alone and don't feel really right. It was really hard. But when I started there, I went to thank the teachers who was interviewing me and they said, you did very well and why we wouldn't choose you. You are really the right person to be here in university. I said, thank you. And they said, do you know what? You made a history. I said, why? They say, you are the first Muslim student who is teaching to become a teacher. I said, really? They say, yes. So you made a history. I was like, oh my God, really, seriously? Like I have been in Finland so many years, like 20 years, and I'm going to make a history. Why? Okay, I was happy at the same time, but sad same time. why there haven't been someone else before me? There should have been someone else before me, not me after 20 years being in Finland, making history. That's really, no. I couldn't believe that. But when I started in university, the students didn't take me well. Every time wherever I go, wherever I walk, the students start to stare at me everywhere. I remember when I went to the lunch, had a lunch break, everybody was talking first, blah, 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 blah. Then I got in to the lunch hall and everybody stopped talking and stare at me like, there she go, there she is. Like, I don't know what I was, but it was annoying. It was really, really annoying. Like, why they are staring at me? Like, am I not human? Am I just animal? What I am? Really, really, I was thinking that I'm different. I was all the time thinking that no, I'm not different. I'm really trying to prove everybody I'm not different at all. But they make me feel like, yes, I am different. It was really annoying. It was really, really annoying. And I was thinking all the time that I'm not really welcome to there. I shouldn't be there. I'm not like one of them. I should be like them, but I'm not like them. And it was really bothering me all the time. So I was thinking all the time, I should quit the studies. I should go back to my mom's place. I should have listened to my mom. I should have, because it was easier way. It was really easier way than being in university where you have to study all the time and you have to face all the troubles and face the challenges and face the people, the society and everything. It was really, really not really nice time for me. I really felt like this. I wanted to feel like I fit there and to belong there, but I really didn't fit there. I really didn't fit there. Every time and everywhere I go, they just saw me and noticed me and I am different, even though I wanted to belong there and I wanted to fit there, but I know I didn't fit there. And I was thinking all the time, who am I? Can I be myself? Like, they are really destroying my identity. I had this own picture, like, I am teacher and I'm going to be a teacher and I'm a good teacher. But they were saying something else. They were really looking at me like differently and talking me different way. And it was really, really annoying. So I kept thinking, who am I? Can I be this person? Should I take my headscarf off? Should I change my name? Should I change my religion to become a teacher like them? So I was really thinking, am I a teacher or am I something else? Because they kept thinking that I'm just immigrant. They keep talking me like I'm an immigrant and they keep watching me like I'm an immigrant. So they didn't believe who I am. So it was really, really hard time for me to think who I am and to build my identity. It was really hard. And I needed all the support, but nobody was really supporting me. Nobody. So I really felt like this at one point. Everybody was putting their hands up and telling me, no, you are not going this way, and you are not going to this way, and you are not welcome this way. And they were really building the walls. My mother was building, the society was building, the students in university, they were building, everybody was building like the walls for me. And not, you know, showing me the direction, not supporting me. I was really alone, and I really felt like this, alone. And I don't know, but I kept moving. The second thing that the students start to ask different questions from me, like all kind of questions. They start seeing me everywhere, so they had to, you know, understand me, and they had to understand who am I and what I'm doing and what is my dream. Do I really want to be a teacher? Do I really want the same thing? Do we really have the same dreams? Really? Am I really going to stay in Finland and teach the Finnish students? Really? Do I really have the same things with them? So they kept really asking everything. They kept asking me, how do I speak Finnish so well? So I was like, yeah, I should speak Finnish this well because I have lived like 20 years in Finland. Now I have lived 27 years. So yes, I should speak very well. So they kept talking with me in English first. I was like, why are you talking in English? Really? Like every time when I went somewhere, they were talking to me in English. And I was like, should I talk with them in English or should I just reply in Finnish? No, I replied it in Finnish. And they were like, oh, you can speak Finnish. Oh, yes, yes. Oh, you have lived here. Yes, yes, 20 years. Yes. So they were really surprised about everything. So I realized they don't really understand who I am and my history. And that's normal. That's really normal. And I should accept that they don't really understand anything about me. But I should make something. I should make differences. I should take one step and just, you know, talk with them and explain everything to them. So what was bothering me, they were all the time asking me, how did I get into the university? Did I make the same exam? Did I have the same exam book? Did I have the same exam? Like, I was really thinking that, are they really thinking I'm that stupid? Really? Like, do I really have a small brain? What they are thinking? So I had to explain then, yes, I did the same exam. Yes, I was sitting there 3 hours. I was doing the same thing. I was answering the same question. I didn't have easier test. They thought that. And they thought I have had in English the test. No, I didn't have really. So that question was really bothering me all the time because they were thinking that I really don't have the skills. The second question that they asked, will you ever graduate? Will you ever graduate? Is this hard for you? Can you understand everything when you are reading? No, I don't understand and I don't think you understand everything either. I see you sleeping in lectures like me. Like, no, we don't really understand everything. Yes, that's a normal thing. But yes, I graduated in a normal time with the others, but they really didn't believe that I could graduate. And when I graduated, they were like, oh, you did it. They were like, not, hey, congratulations. Yes. Oh, you did it. Oh, yes, I did it. Yes, yes, yes. That was the point. I graduate and I keep teaching. So, yeah. And they kept asking about my religion, why I'm wearing this headscarf, can I take it off? If I'm going to teach, can I take it off? How people are really going to talk with me if I'm wearing this? Can I sing with this scarf? Can I do sport? Like really, really weird question. And I was like all the time laughing. And my teachers, they were, because I was the first immigrant students with them. So my teachers kept asking me all the time, is it okay for you this, if it's okay for this? For example, we have this music lesson. We have to take music lesson and art and everything and sport. So we had music lesson. And my teacher was singing in Christmas about Jesus. And they were singing all loud about Jesus, how they love Jesus and everything. And then she noticed me there and she was like, oh my God, oh my God. So she stopped and then she came to me and she was like, I'm very, very sorry. I don't know. But she was really nervous. She didn't know how to, you know, talk with me. Did I offend you? Why? Did I offend your religion? No, no, you didn't. Really? Because we were singing about Jesus. I said, did you know that in Islam we love Jesus? And she was like, oh my God, no, 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 this is new information. Good that you are telling me. So they didn't know either about me and my culture, and my religion. So they were surprised. I was like, oh, they don't either know anything about me. So I have to explain everything. The same thing, my art teacher was giving a lecture and he was showing some slideshow about naked man, and also he realized me sitting somewhere there and he was embarrassed and he was showing the slides and he was watching me and watching like, oh my God, oh my God. Okay, the lecture was over and he came to me, run for me, and he was like, Zahara. I said, yes, I'm very, very sorry. I'm very, very sorry. Did I offend you? your religion? I said, no, why? Because they were naked men, and I know you in your religion, you cannot do that. I was like, no, I was enjoying myself. So he was laughing also. So I thought that, yes, the humor is the one key to everything. So I have to make everything in humor. So it was really nice. It was really nice. And they kept asking me, can I shake your hand? And I was like, yes, can I take your soft hand and just squeeze that? Yes. Exactly. And they were laughing all the time, like, oh my God, you are so funny. Can you be so funny? Yes, I can be really, I can be funny if I want to be. Yes. The third stage was understanding. When they understood everything, it was really easy for me, for them, for the teacher, for everybody. They were really accepting me. They were really understanding me. The working was easier when we had to work in groups. It was really easier to work with everybody. They knew exactly who I am and what I was thinking and my religion and my culture, everything. I had to just explain everything all the time. But I remember the first month was horrible because nobody wanted to make the pair work or the group work with me. So I always was the last one sitting alone. And it was really, really annoying. And when we had to work in groups, there was one girl I remember very, very well. The one girl didn't even look at my eyes when we were working in the groups. She was not watching me. When I was talking, she was watching somewhere else. I was like, seriously? I haven't done anything bad to you, and you don't know me, and I don't know you, I haven't hurt you, so why you are not watching me when I talk with you, to you? No. But yes, when they knew me, they understood me, so the work was easier. And it was easier for me also to go forward and think that yes, I'm really one of them, and I'm really going to graduate, and I belong here, and I really feel good. So the fourth one was accepting me. So I was thinking that, okay, I'm not that different at all. So it's really good. I know that I'm different, and it's a good thing because we are really all different. That's really good thing. And I felt like I'm one of them and I belong them. And we share the same interest. We all have the same dream. The same goal. We really want to teach the students, and we want to develop everything, the education, and build good society, and they don't notice that from me. So that was a good thing. So in the end, before I graduated from the university, so I became a multicultural expert in the university. So they kept taking me everywhere, like, Zahara, can you come here? Like, can you give a lecture about multicultural? Can you give about this speech? And can you do this and do this? And every time when we have had visitors from abroad, so they took me, like, can you show them this school? Yes, I can do that. So yeah, it was really nice, really, really nice that they really kept thinking that I'm multicultural expert, something special, you know, from me. So it was really nice. So I was the special one, and they kept talking like, you are our pride, like, yes, you are one of us, and you are the best one and the special one, and we also send you, if we have anything, we send you to speak, to show people that we really have something special, and nobody really have that special but us, and we made the history. So they were really, really proud of that. So what it takes, first thing from me, courage to make the first step, patience, of course, understanding from them and from me, to understand that really they don't really understand everything, and I should really show who I am to let them understand. Lots of humor, like make everything humor so you can break the ice with them. So the last thing, let's see the time. Yes, the last thing I put it here, this, and I think this is really great because we sometimes really want to belong somewhere, but in the end, it's a good thing that we don't belong anywhere, because that's when we realize that we belong everywhere. I think that's the greatest thing. And I realized that I really belong everywhere. And I fit in everywhere I want. I really do. So I want to thank you. And I want to end up here and give time for us. Thank you.